Hello everyone, I welcome you to the live session for Lakshmi Consult Overseas Consultancy. I am representing University of Northern British Columbia, which is situated at Prince George in British Columbia province. In today's session, I am going to cover what exactly my university is all about. Okay, not just the university, but the location, the programs that I have, like why you should be studying in that particular university, that is in UNBC. And also I'll definitely cover the points what are the effects of COVID-19 on overseas education for UNBC. Okay, so here I start. UNBC, that is University of Northern British Columbia, is situated at Prince George in British Columbia province in Canada. It is ranked as top 3 in Canada for more than a decade by Maclean's magazine for small universities. According to the Times Higher Education World Ranking, it is featured under the group ranking of 801 to 1000th rank, right? That is top 5% worldwide. My university, UNBC, has emerged as one of the young elite universities in the worldwide, right? So basically, if I talk to you about UNBC, it is a public intensive research based university with the award winning excellence, like top 3 ranked in Canada for small universities for more than a decade, top 5% worldwide according to the Times Higher Education, and also emerged as a young elite university. Now let us talk to you about the location. Prince George. UNBC is situated at Prince George. Prince George is a very famous city in northern side of the British Columbia. In fact, it is also known as the capital of northern British Columbia. The population of Prince George is around 85,000 to 90,000. Right, so it's not a estranged or isolated place, it's a proper city. So the international students who are traveling to Prince George or who are traveling to Canada and going to Prince George would definitely experience the Canadian culture over there, the ultra modernized or multicultural kind of a culture. They're definitely gonna experience over there. So that's about Prince George culture. Now let me help you out with the weather conditions of Prince George. Prince George observes 4 seasons a year. Now these are summer, spring, fall and winter. The average temperatures for this particular seasons are, for summer it is around 25 degrees Celsius, that's the average daytime temperature. For spring it is plus 16 degrees Celsius. For fall it is plus 8, and for winter it is minus 8 degrees Celsius, that's the average daytime temperature. So Prince George observes 299 days of sunshine, which means it's like out of 12 months, good 10 months are of sunshine and only 2 months are of extreme cold condition. So it is very much easier for the Indian students, or it is very much comfortable for the international students to cope up with the drastic changes in the climatic conditions, right? So it is very much helpful for the students to get over there, and not just get comfortable, but it is easier for their life also, for the living costs as well. That I'll definitely help you out in the proceeding in the coming section, right? Now let me help you. One more thing about Prince George's. Prince George is also known as 20 minute city. So everything is in and around 20 minutes. If you want to go to your downtown or your residential area or your campus or any something related to entertainment, it is just 20 minutes away. So Prince George is a 20 minute city. That's one thing. The earning capacities of Prince George is pretty high. The cost of living is pretty low. The standard of living is pretty high. So that is a brief about Prince George. Now let me help you out with detailed programs that I have at UNBC. Okay, I have already mentioned, let me mention once again, right? UNBC, that is University of Northern British Columbia, is a public intensive research based university. It has been considered, it is very much, the education system and the course and curriculum is very much similar to the University of British Columbia. It has been compared with the University of British Columbia or Simon Fraser University or University of Victoria. So, accordingly or in correspondence with these kind of universities, we also have research-based programs, right? That's one thing. Now, all my programs, I basically, as I told you, I am an intensive research-based university. So, all my programs are research-based only, right? And all the program I deal with UG, that is undergraduate. UNBC, India office supports undergraduate studies a lot. So, all of my programs are UG programs and one MBA program. I shall help you out in detail in the I'll be explaining you the programs, right? So the programs that I have are of 120 credit points, that is of 4 years programs. You can complete it in 3 years. The main point is you need to complete 120 credit points for your bachelor's degree. That's the important thing. You can stretch your course for 3 years or 4 years. That's completely dependent from the student to student. However, it is highly recommended to complete your program in 4 years. The next thing is the programs that I have. I have a matrix of 37 programs, right? UNBC has a matrix of 37 programs which are categorized into two: competitive programs and non-competitive programs. Competitive programs are three, okay? These three programs are Bachelor's of Applied Science, Civil Engineering, Bachelor's of Applied Science, Environmental Engineering, and Bachelor's of Health Science, Biomedical Studies. These three are the competitive programs and the rest 34 are non-competitive programs. Now let us begin with the competitive programs. The competitive programs, that is Civil Engineering, Environmental Engineering, and Health Science program. First, I'll help you out with the intake. I just have one intake for the competitive program, and that is September intake. The reason being is the course and curriculum is designed in such a way that most majority of the courses start in the September month. So we have only one intake. Not just that, it is being highly recommended or highly competitive because most of the Canadian students, it is very famous amongst the Canadian students, and most of the Canadian students definitely want to study these kind of programs from UNBC. So it's very popular program amongst Canadian students. So these are the two major reasons why it is competitive and why we have only one intake for that. The second thing I would like to cover is about the academic requirements for competitive programs. The academic requirements for competitive programs, that is Civil Engineering, Environmental Engineering, Biomedical Studies, are like 65% overall with no less than 60% in each of the core modules. Let me repeat, it is 65% overall with no less than 60% in each of the core modules, right? Now, IELTS requirements or language proficiency test. Initially, we used to accept only IELTS and TOEFL. IELTS with 6.5, no less than 6 bands in each. That is overall 6.5, no less than 6 in each of the modules. That's one thing, right? And we used to accept TOEFL IBT, that is TOEFL Internet Based Test, which is total points are 120 points, out of which you would require 90 points overall and 20 points in each of the components as in reading, listening, speaking and writing for TOEFL, right? But due to COVID-19, we are however accepting English Duolingo and IELTS indicators. English Duolingo with 105 points and IELTS indicators, again it is 6.5 with no less than 6 in each. Now, one thing is, this is subjected to only COVID-19, and for September and Jan 21 intake, it is so English Duolingo or IELTS indicators are not like, you know, these are temporary, you know, requirements which you need to fulfill for the admission and for the application process, right? So if like you know if there are no examinations happening for IELTS, that's perfectly fine. You can get into you know English Duolingo and you can get into your IELTS indicators, get your bands done, get your scores done, and you can apply and start applying and start studying for September intake. And I'll help you out with you know the online classes that we're gonna have. But before that, I would like to give you brief about the programs, that is competitive programs. Because it's easier to, you know, it would be easier for you to make decision whether to go for this kind of a program or not, right? So the first thing is Bachelor's of Applied Science, Civil Engineering. So Civil Engineering obviously works on the basic principles that we have, that is construction, manufacturing, development, reconstruction, infrastructure development, renovation and everything, right? So that's the same thing that you're gonna study. Of course, the required subjects would be physics, chemistry and mathematics. Same thing, 65% overall with no less than 16 each of the physics, chemistry and mathematics. That's one thing. The second program that I'm going to discuss is Bachelor's of Applied Science, Environmental Engineering. In Environmental Engineering, it works on two different phenomena, right? The maintaining the environment and the second is improving the environment. So environmental engineering works on these two different phenomena, that is maintaining and improving the environment. This is particularly new for Indian students to understand, but yes, so basically we're gonna have environmental studies with the scientific approach or with the engineering approach. That's gonna be there that you're gonna study in environmental engineering program. Now the important point is the required subjects. You would be confused whether to like you know biology is required or not, mathematics is required or not. In that case, let me you know help you out. The mandatory subjects are physics and chemistry. Okay, so the mandatory subjects are physics and chemistry. So even if you are a B group student or even if you have biology and you do not have mathematics, that's perfectly fine. You can get into environmental engineering program. Now one thing about my university is my university has understood one thing, that you know Indian students do not have bio and mathematics together for the majority of the group of the people. So in that case they have been very flexible for the math requirement. Now what does that mean is basically if you do not have mathematics in your grade 12, that is pre-calculus level mathematics in your grade 12, that's perfectly fine. You can still apply, you can still get the admissions at UNBC, that's one thing. And not just that, if there is a prerequisite of your, you know, if there is a prerequisite of pre-calculus level mathematics for any of the courses that is going to be there, in that case, you will be studying math 115 over there at the university parallelly with the program that you're gonna have. Abhi iska matlab kya hota hai? It's basically so agar aapka agar you I just said that like you know before I said that you have 120 credit points that you have to earn over the period of 4 years, that is 8 semesters. So that means every semester you're gonna study 15 credit points. 15 credit points up every semester padenge. That means you're gonna study 5 different courses because one course is equivalent to 3 credit points. Now course is nothing but subjects that we call in India, right? Jaise hum log subjects bolte hain, they call it courses. So basically aap 5 subjects padenge, theek hai? Jab 5 subjects padenge, then you will be earning 15 credit points. Clear? Now this means that if you're going for environmental engineering, you'll definitely be requiring mathematics, that is calculus, pre-calculus level mathematics. And if you are a bio group student, you would definitely not be well versed with the pre-calculus level mathematics. In that case, you'll be taking up the programs which would not require you would be taking courses or subjects which would not require mathematics as their prerequisite, right? And so let's say you'll take physics, you'll take bio 1, you can take chemistry 1 or inorganic chemistry or whatever the subjects that would be required for environmental studies, right? You're gonna take that and at the same point of time you will be doing math 115 at the university along with your different courses, that is the 5 different courses, and you can clear your math 115 in 3-2 weeks program, right? Get get your grades done, and from the next semester you can definitely go for your mathematics study. So that is about, you know, the mathematics requirement and also math 115. The cost of math 115 is included in your first year's tuition fees. Let me repeat, the cost for math 115 is included in your tuition fees itself. So that's about math 115. This is true for all the different disciplines that we have. That is, even if you are a commerce student and you do not have mathematics, that's perfectly fine. If you are from science B group student and if your desired program required prerequisite of maths, that is pre-calculus level mathematics, that's perfectly fine. You can apply, get the admissions at UNBC, complete it in the first semester, and you're good to go with that particular program, right? So that was about engineering program and about the programs that you would require, right? The next thing I would like to help you out is with biomedical studies. Yes, so that is bachelor's of health science with biomedical studies. Students, I want you to be very clear about one thing, that is, in Canada you cannot directly become a pharmacist or a dentist or maybe a medical or you cannot study medicine directly in Canada. For that, the very important point is you need to first earn 120 credit points in medicinal related programs, that is paramedicals, biomedicals, biology programs. Let's say if you want to go for physiotherapy, for kinesiology also works, right? So that's one thing. Now, the next thing I would like to help you out with this, amongst these courses or amongst these programs, biomedical studies facilitate or would help you out to earn maximum credit points. So the students who wish to go for, you know, studies like pharmacy, dentistry or something like that, in that particular case, they can definitely get into biomedical studies first, earn their 120 credit points. Okay, so now this is little bit extra information, which is not like this is beyond UNBC, that is. So you earn these 120 credit points, you have to, you know, give the entrance test for a particular program. Let's say if you want to go for pharmacy, you will be giving PCAT, or if you want to go for medicine, you can go for MCAT, right? Then if you clear the entrance test, after that you're gonna study more 60 or 90 credit points depending on the credit points that you have got in your bachelor's degree, that is BS levels, okay, or undergrad levels, right? Now depending on those credits, you'll be studying more 60 or 90 credits, that is the total would be of 180 to 210 credit points, okay? And then once you get those points, once you earn those credit points, and if you qualify for the licensure exam, right, then you'll be definitely giving the licensure exam and can become the practitioners like pharmacist or physiotherapist or dentist. For medicine, again, that's a long process that will definitely, Lakshmi Overseas will definitely help you out with that. Students, let me be very honest with you, Lakshmi Overseas is a very prominent and eminent consultancy for foreign education, and you will definitely yield good results for IELTS, not just for IELTS, but also they are very well versed with the end-to-end processes. So definitely, whatever your doubts are or whatever your things are, you can definitely contact Lakshmi Overseas Consultancy, and if it is related to UNBC, they'll definitely post it to me and I'll definitely help you out with that. Okay, coming back to the UNBC programs that I have. Okay, so I was explaining you about biomedical studies. Yes, you have to earn 120 credit points, and obviously the required subjects would be physics, chemistry and biology in your grade 12. So let me just brief you out about the competitive programs I have. I have three competitive programs, that is Bachelor's of Applied Science, Civil Engineering, Bachelor's of Applied Science, Environmental Engineering, Bachelor's of Health Science in Biomedical Studies. These are the three competitive programs that I have. I just have one intake, that is September intake. Okay, the academic requirements are 65% overall with no less than 60 points in each of the core modules. That's one thing. And the next thing is the language proficiency test requirements. Now there are four, that is IELTS, 6.5, no less than 6 in each. TOEFL, IBT, which is total 120 points, you would require, like rather, UNBC would require 90 points overall with no less than 20 in each of the components. Due to COVID-19, we are accepting IELTS English, accepting IELTS indicator 6.5, no less than 6 in each, and English Duolingo with 105 points. This was brief about competitive programs. Yes, I forgot to mention the fee structure. So the fees, the tuition fees is around 22K, that is 22,000. But if you add up to everything, like let's say books and materials, or let's say student fees and all, so the consolidated amount for 1 year is around 25,165, that is 25,165 Canadian dollars per annum, which means for 2 semesters where you can earn at least 30 credit points. Okay, so this is true for all the competitive programs that I have. Now let me move on to the non-competitive programs that I have. My non-competitive programs are categorized into 3 different disciplines. Now these 3 disciplines are arts, science and commerce, that is bachelor's of arts, bachelor's of science and bachelor's of commerce. So I have good 34 programs, out of which 14 are for arts, 13 are for science and 7 are for commerce. Let's begin with the ascending order, that is bachelor's of commerce with 7 programs that I have, that is BCom. The 7 programs are BCom in accounting, right? So this BCom in accounting is like the BCom program that we have in India, right? Here lekin ek cheez aur ek bar bata do, bhale India mein BCom 3 saal ka hai, all my programs are of 120 credit points and are of 4 years. So please make sure that all the programs are of 120 credit points and 4 years. So even if I say BCom, just don't feel that it's just a BCom or something like that. It's BCom where you're gonna study the accounting principles in that, right? So that's one program that I have. Now the next 5 programs that I'm gonna discuss now are like the business related programs, but then they are categorized into BCom itself. Now these 5 programs are, of course, finance, HRM, that is human resource management, marketing, international business studies and general business studies. Now these 5 programs are related to your BBA program that you have in India. However, in Canada at UNBC we call it BCom only, and we call it as specializations, as I've just mentioned, that is BCom in finance, BCom in HRM, that is human resource management, BCom in marketing, BCom in general business studies, and BCom in international business studies. So these are 5 different programs, right? So total is 6. Now the 7th program for BCom is MIS, Management Information System. BCom in MIS. Now MIS, what does this MIS mean, Management Information System? If you go through online, you'll definitely know that. But just let me help you out with a small example for MIS so that it is clear to you what exactly MIS would be, right? Let's say if you are looking for some phone and if you Google it, right? Let's say you're looking for a Samsung phone and you Google it. So if you open up your Insta, Facebook or Snapchat, you're gonna see the same ads. Why does this happen? This happens because you have generated a lead on a Google or maybe on internet. I would not just use Google, but on internet. Let's say if you're using Bing or Mozilla or anything, right? So whatever you're gonna use, whatever internet supporter that you're gonna use, that's gonna be there, right? In that case, all the different social media platforms, let's say Instagram or Facebook or Snapchat, you're gonna see the same ads, or maybe ads related to that, maybe the accessories for phones or headphones or chargers, AirPods, anything, right? Now why does this happen is you have generated a lead, and somehow somebody who's sitting back in the computer or back behind the system would understand that you are in need of this kind of things, and these things kind of pop up on your mobile screen and you can get into the impulsive buying for that. So that's basically Management Information System. It would definitely help you out with lead generation, data analysis and data analytics. So that's a very good program. Usually this program was for first masters, but now my university has understood the you know, need of an hour. So we have started at a very nascent stage at an undergraduate level. So it's a very good course and perfect blend of computer and, you know, commerce studies or management studies. So BCom in MIS is a very good program. So these are my 7 different programs for commerce, that is BCom. Now let me move on to science, because I said we're going to go for ascending manner. So 7 and then 13. So I have 13 different programs for science. Bachelor's of Science, okay. Of course, there are 4 pillars for Bachelor's of Science, that is Physics, Chemistry, Maths and Bio. We're going to, I do have all these 4 programs, that is BSc in Science, BSc in Biology, BSc in Physics, BSc in Chemistry, BSc in, of course, mathematics. Now let me help you out with the different programs that I have. That is, one program is BS in Biochemistry and Molecular Biology. Now this program is like a very good program for the students, the biology students, right? Usually biology students are left with very less options apart from the medical studies, right? This is a very good program that is Biochemistry and Molecular Biology. Molecular Biology is all about, you know, genetics, DNA molecules, RNA molecules, and whatever happens at a very cell level and a molecular level. So that is about Biochemistry and Molecular Biology. Of course, related subjects are Physics, Chemistry and Biology. Okay. One more program that I have for Biology is BSc in Psychology. Students, that is BSc in Psychology. What we have it in India is BA in Psychology. Right, but in my university we have BSc in Psychology, so the required subjects are Physics, Chemistry and Biology. Right, Physics, Chemistry and Biology. Now let me help you out with the difference between BA and BSc program. BA in Psychology is all about awareness, it is all about consulting and all. But BSc in Psychology is not only about awareness, consulting or counseling, but it is also about therapies and healing processes. In the longer run, if you, you know, have the required expertise, you can become a psychiatrist as well. Usually psychologist, and there's a difference between psychologist and psychiatrist. You can definitely Google that over the, you know, internet. But yes, you can become psychiatrist as well by this course. Now the details, I'll definitely, you can go down to www.unbc.ca, that's my website, /programs, and you'll definitely help, that will definitely help you out with the programs that I have. Okay. The next thing I would help you out with, the other program, that is BSc in Computer Science. Now this, there is a good news for you Indian students, that is BSc in Computer Science, all the disciplines can apply for that with definitely terms and conditions applied. Yes. So the Bachelor's of Science, Computer Science, B group students can apply, that is Physics, Chemistry, Biology. Yes, obviously Physics, Chemistry, Math students can apply. But if you are a commerce student, right, still you can apply for BSc in Computer Science, but the condition is, or you would require to have pre-calculus level mathematics in your grade 12, which means even though if you're a commerce student and if you have mathematics in your grade 12, you can definitely apply for computer science. If you're an art student, okay, let's say if you're an art student, okay, because art students do not have mathematics in their grade 12, that's for sure. In that case, you need to have 60% plus in your mathematics in your grade 10. So the good news is, usually universities in Canada do not have this, you know, interdiscipline kind of an, you know, admission process. But my university gives it for computer science, right? So that is BSc in Computer Science. The other program is Bachelor's of Environmental Science. Again, it's gonna be like about environmental studies. Oh, by the way, my university is also known as Canada's Green University. We focus a lot on environmental studies. As you are into this session, you would have understood I have Environmental Engineering program, Bachelor's of Science, Environmental Studies, and in Arts also I have Environmental and Sustainability Studies, which means that we focus a lot on environmental studies. Not just that, we have our own bioenergy plant, that has been instilled at my university, which reduces the carbon footprint, okay, carbon footprint is nothing but the amount of carbons that you emit every per square kilometer, that is like subjected to person or an entity to an institution, everything is there. But if I talk to you about the bioenergy plant that I have at my university, that's the university's carbon footprint. So we have reduced the carbon footprint by 85%, in turn, you know, decrease the pollution or decrease the fossil fuel consumption by almost 90%. That's one thing. Now, what does this basic mean is, right? Of course, my university is known as Canada's Green University. Not just that, but we also believe in blended learning. Now, what is blended learning? Blended learning is basically whatever you have studied in your, you know, theory, you're gonna apply it on your practicals. That is nothing but a blended learning, right? So, yes, I have deviated a little bit about it, but yes, that's a very good piece of information that I wanted to give you. That is the education pattern. Okay, let me complete it and then definitely I'll resume to the programs that I was discussing about. So the education pattern that UNBC has is basically, we believe in, you know, experiential learning, you know, on-field trainings, blended learning, right? Collaborative teaching techniques we have for that. So basically we focus, like, you know, we have the, you know, perfect mix. Blend is nothing but mix. We have the perfect mix of theory and your practicals, so that whatever you have studying, you're studying in your theory, you're gonna definitely apply the same in your practicals. And the biggest example is of bioenergy plant. Right, that was the main thing that I wanted to discuss with you. Okay, now let me resume it to the programs in science. I have helped you with six different programs. The seventh was environmental science. Yes, now the different other program is BSc in integrated science. Integrated science is nothing but you're gonna study more than two subjects together, right? That is, let's say ecology, biology, ecology, biochemistry and molecular biology altogether, then earth and environmental science together, geography and GIC altogether. So that is, these are nothing but the integrated programs that I have. Okay, the other program that I have is wildlife and fisheries. So it is definitely be related to wildlife and fisheries, that is aquatic animals. Not just that, but the businesses related to that, that is like horticulture or sericulture or whatever it is being linked with that. So of course you're gonna study that, that is, you know, wildlife and fisheries. I also have BSc in geography. Now BSc in geography is different from BA in geography, of course, in the approach, not just in the approach but in also in the job prospects. You can definitely go through the website and understand the programs, the courses required and the job prospects related to that. The other thing that I would like to explain you is forest ecology and management. That is like if you want to become a forest officer or something like that, you can definitely go get into forest ecology and management. Alright, the last two programs that I want to discuss is that is conservation science and practices. Conservation science and practices, I have two. One is wildlife and the other is landscape. So wildlife is all about the species that is getting, you know, extinct day by day, and the imbalance is created by that, this extinction on the ecosystem. That's one thing. And the next thing, landscape is like, you know, the day by day the land is getting degraded, the quality of crops or the quality of food that we are eating is different from what we used to have like 400-500 years back. Now this is all about the why. It is because it is getting, you know, degraded, right? Now let me help you out with one last line about conservation science. Conservation science and practices, this works on the preservation, you know, preserving kind of a principle. So that is all about the science programs that I have. Students who are putting comments or the questions on the comment section will definitely get back to you. The panelists would be writing you down. If not, I'll definitely reply on the comment section, because I cannot do, you know, same, like, you know, while explaining, I won't be able to do your doubts, but I'll definitely help you out with the doubt clearance. Once I complete this session, I'll go through your comment section, else the panelists would definitely help you out with that. You can definitely contact Lakshmi Overseas and I'll help you out with that. So please put your questions or your doubts on the comment section, and don't worry, all your answers would be addressed soon. That's not an issue. Okay, so that was one the important thing. The different programs that I have for arts is Bachelor's of Arts. I have 14 different programs. I'm gonna help you out with the detail of that. The 14 different programs are BA in Anthropology, that Anthropology study of human being. Students, I do not have BA in Psychology, but if a student who's from arts background and wants to study psychology can get into BA in Anthropology, where the courses are similar to, you know, psychology, because psychology gonna study human behaviors and all, right? Same thing you're gonna study in Anthropology. Anthropology study of human beings. Okay, where you'll be studying definitely evolution from apes to Homo sapiens sapiens. Not just that, you're gonna definitely also study everything about human behaviors, how they are different, what were the primitive times, what are the medieval times, and what are the modern times and all. So you're definitely gonna study all of these in, you know, Anthropology. Apart from that, we're gonna of course study the, you know, behaviors, human behaviors. So if you want to study psychology or something like that, I do not have the psychology course at UNBC, but however I have it, you know, I have Anthropology course. And the again course which is related to Anthropology is again women's study. So I have a different section altogether for women, that is like Bachelor's of Arts in Women's Study, where you're gonna study everything about women, like their empowerment, the human behavior, the culture that they have, or why they behave in particular manner. Like it is said that women cannot, you know, read maps. So why they do not read maps or are unable to read maps. So you're gonna study that in that. Okay, the next thing, like I have all the different programs of arts which we have it in India, that is history, geography, English, right? Then general arts, which are similar to that what we have. That's one thing. The different other programs are Northern Studies, First Nation Studies, then Public Administration and Community Development. If you're into communities or developing the communities or something like that, you can definitely get into that. Okay, Bhargav, I'll definitely get back to you how to register for the online courses and all. Don't worry. Okay, Bhargav. Okay, I'm sorry, I was getting constant questions from Bhargav, so that's why I addressed it. But yes, I was talking to you about the different programs of arts. I was talking about, First Nation Studies, then Northern Studies, then Public Administration and Community Development, where if you are into, you know, NGO studies, or if you are into uplift the community, right? In that case, you can go for Public Administration and Community Development kind of studies. I also have Nature-Based Tourism Management. Now, what does this mean is basically if you want to become a travel blogger and explore each and every corner of the world, you can definitely get into this kind of an, you know, professional training, that is, you know, BA in Nature-Based Tourism Management. It is basically like you must have all of have watched movie of Ranbir Kapoor. का जो job होता है, like he is a blogger, he goes to places and he explores different culture or something like that. So that is like, you know, dramatized version of what your study would be, right? Yes, dramatized version of your study. Basically, you're gonna be having, you will be working as a travel blogger a little later on. Okay, so these are the different programs that I have for arts. If I missed on, definitely Lakshmi Overseas will help you out with that. Okay, that is all about the programs that I have. Now, let me help you out with the different, you know, this thing, the intakes that I have. For this non-competitive programs, I have all the three intakes, that is September, January and May. Right now we are accepting, you know, profiles or applications for September 2020 as well as Jan 2021. Okay, now the important part is, let me finish the academic requirements, IELTS requirements and everything, and I'll definitely help you out with COVID-19 situation, what you can do for that. right? So please stay tuned and let me just complete the things that I wanted to complete. So I have explained you the programs that I have, the intakes, okay? Now the next thing I wanted to let you know is about academic requirements. So the academic requirements are 55% overall with no less than 50 in each of the core modules. It is 55% overall with no less than 50 in each of the core modules. That's one thing. Okay, the second thing is IELTS requirements. It's similar to the competitive programs, that is like IELTS 6.5 no less than 6 in each, TOEFL IBT 90 overall with no less than 20 in each of the components, IELTS indicators, okay, that is again 6.5 no less than 6 in each, and English Duolingo with 105 points. So these are the English language, you know, language proficiency test requirements. The fee structure, it is around 20,000 Canadian dollars. That is 20,000 Canadian dollars. I'm sorry, not 20,000. It's 20,000 Canadian dollars. That is again per annum. Okay, and again it is for 2 semesters. So students, let me be very clear with you. One thing is the academic over year is for 8 months and the calendar year is of course of 12 months. So don't get confused between the academic year and the calendar year. That's one thing. So your semester are like 2 semesters in a year, that is 8 months, and that's how you can work for 20 hours per week and 40 hours per week. Now let me begin with the COVID-19 situation. So the very first thing about COVID-19 is we have started accepting English Duolingo and IELTS indicators. That's the plus point. Even though if there are no IELTS examinations happening with IDP or British Council, that's perfectly fine. You can take up, you know, the online tests like English Duolingo or IELTS indicators. IELTS indicators are just the same, okay, but the only thing is you're gonna sit at home and gonna give your examination. Duolingo is again an online test where all the modules are listening, reading, writing and speaking, which is similar to the language proficiency test, so you can definitely get into that. The best part is you're gonna get the score online. So with this score, you can apply for it. The second good part about UNBC application process is even though if you have not given your grade 12 examination, you can still apply on your basis of your 11th or your predictive scores. Now I understand that most of the examinations, like 1 or 2 papers are pending for different boards, especially CBSE board and all, right? So that's perfectly fine. You can still apply on the predictive scores. That's one thing, okay? And also I can help you out with other things, if not the predictive scores also, you can apply it on your grade 11th mark sheet. So that's very good thing, okay? About September intake, right? Whether it is online, whether it is offline, and what if the cross borders are not open, how are you supposed to go for it? So I am gonna help you out with that. One thing, this is totally subjected to UNBC only, okay? It is totally subjected to University of Northern British Columbia, okay? My September program, my September intake is online program, okay? So it is online where you can pick up 3 to 5 courses. That is, you can earn up to 9 to 15 credit points. That would qualify you for the full-time thing. That's one thing, okay? Now the types of courses are synchronized or asynchronized depending upon the course that you select. The second thing is 80% of your course is online for the September intake. Now this is because there is a uncertainty in the cross-border traveling till date and High Commission is not yet open. So in that case, we are not sure about the September intake, and that's why we have got into online programs or online courses for the students. Now the best part about it is, if you do not have study permit, you can still go for this kind of courses. You can still pick up the courses. No need to pay the complete tuition fees for that. You can pay the deposit amount, that is 7,500 Canadian dollars. And if you are still applying under SDS program, you can top it up to the full year tuition fees and get your visas done. Let's say if you got into UNBC, that is University of Northern British Columbia, okay, and if you have not applied for student visa, yet you have started with the online courses, that's perfectly fine. Okay, and if cross borders, let's say, open in the month of September, you can travel in the month of October. However, your course would be online, but you can still go there, can use the amenities of UNBC. That's one thing. And it would not affect your postgraduate work permits. So students, you can definitely go for that. Okay. The PR processes would definitely, Lakshmi Overseas will help you out with that. In general, let me help you out with one thing is, if you are going to UNBC, you're going to stay at Prince George. And you will get 5 extra points if you're staying at Prince George of adaptability. So the PR processes are quite simpler, easier and faster if you're staying at Prince George in British Columbia province. So that's one thing I would like to add on. About COVID-19 situation, all the programs are online for September intake. Please do not get panic whether you can go for it or not. It's a very safe option. You can go for online courses. Take up to 3 to 5 courses. That is 9 to 15 credit points. It's better if you take 5 courses over here online. Then you can travel to Canada and get your things done. That is a very easy, safe and a good option for the students, where you cannot have to wait for your dreams to get shattered or something like that. So that's one thing about COVID-19 situation. Now let me help you out with the earning capacities at British Columbia. That's the one thing that most of the students want to understand. So in the introductory section about Prince George, I mentioned that you have less cost of living and high living standards. Now why does this mean? What does this mean is, basically your monthly expenditure, if you're staying at Prince George and are leading a normal student life and staying off campus, in that case your monthly expenditure would be around 550 to 600 Canadian dollars at max. Okay, it won't exceed about 600 Canadian dollars. Yes, of course, ifs and buts are always there. Okay, and if I talk to you about the British Columbia, the bare minimum hourly wages around 12.56. If you calculate for a whole month, minimum amount that you're gonna earn is around 1,000 Canadian dollars. You can earn 1,000 to 1,100 to 1,200 Canadian dollars. Let's say you are earning 1,000 Canadian dollars and you're spending around 600 Canadian dollars. Every month you're saving 400 Canadian dollars. That's one thing. Okay. So this is all about the earning capacity. Not just that, there are plenty of on-campus and off-campus jobs. Now, why does this is? Because on-campus jobs, let me help you out with the on-campus jobs. The on-campus jobs are basically, for second year students onwards, for the students who are second, third and final year, in that case, they can be, TAs, LAs, that is, technical assistants or lab assistants, or they can help the professor into, getting into things done and all. So that's one kind of a job. But if you're a first year student, you would definitely do not have the hands on your technical knowledge. In that case, you can work for cafeterias or housekeeping or administrative work or something like that. So that is true for the on campus jobs. Off campus jobs are plenty in Prince George. The reason being is there are only 2 institutes in Prince George. One is UNBC and the other is College of New Caledonia. In that case, the total number of population is 90,000 in Prince George, and if you calculate the population of UNBC and CNC, that is not more than 10%. In that case, there are plenty of jobs. The skilled people are very less at Prince George comparatively, like the percentage is less, so relatively less. So in that case, there are a number of on campus and off campus jobs for available for your for the students. That's one thing. Now I'll help you out with the graduate employment rate or the job that are available for you after your education, right? The graduate employment rate for on-field jobs, right? On-field jobs, which means जो आपने जिस पढ़ाई में जिस पे पढ़ाई किया है उसी के ऊपर आपका जॉब रहता है, दैट इज़ ऑन फील्ड ग्रेजुएट एम्प्लॉयमेंट रेट, दैट इज़ अराउंड 84%, विच मीन्स अगर आपने जस्ट जो पढ़ाई की है उसी में आप जॉब कर रहे हो, दैट इज़ 84%. बट इफ़ यू आर डूइंग एनी रैंडम जॉब, राइट, दैट इज़ द एम्प्लॉयमेंट रेट, राइट? सो द एम्प्लॉयमेंट रेट फॉर UNBC इज़ मोर देन 95%, बट फॉर ऑन फील्ड ग्रेजुएट एम्प्लॉयमेंट रेट इज़ अराउंड 84%. दैट्स वेरी हाई. इन फैक्ट द सर्वे सेज दैट UNBC स्टूडेंट्स आर हाईली एम्प्लॉयबल. यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ नॉर्दर्न ब्रिटिश कोलंबियन स्टूडेंट्स, दैट इज़ UNBC स्टूडेंट्स आर हाईली employable and they are recommended by most of the employers, or they are highly recommended by the employers at British Columbia. So yes, you are at a very good place, and it's a very good place as in terms of there are lot of opportunities for the students to excel, to have their field jobs. Not just that, the wilderness of the nature and all is very nearby, so they can definitely go for extracurricular activities like mountaining, or they can go for river rafting, or maybe bungee jumping or skiing or something like that. So yes, also my university has many student led organizations. Now that will definitely help to have the exposure with the cross disciplines. In this case, what happens is they will definitely help them to have a good exposure towards that, and that will in turn help them to have an holistic development kind of a scenario. So yes, the university helps you for having a very good exposure. That's one thing. The next thing is the faculty to student ratio. The faculty to student ratio is 1:8, which means every 8 students there is only one faculty. However, this is independent of the class size. Understand one thing, the class size is different from the faculty to student ratio. So in a class there would be around 25, 30, 35, maybe 40 students also, but for every 8 students their go-to person would be for every 8 students there's only one student for that, right? So that's about UNBC. I guess I have covered most of the points. If you have any issues with that, you can definitely contact to Lakshmi Overseas Consultancy. They can help you out with that. They are very much pro or prominent with the end-to-end processes. They'll help you out with the application process and everything about not just my university but also other universities as well. You can definitely get into that. About MBA, I'll just brief you about that. For MBAs, my MBA, the UNBC MBA is of 5 semesters. It has only one intake, that is in August. So the deadline is in December. So whatever you're going to do is you can plan for August 2021 intake. We have 5 semesters. The requirements are IELTS, that is 6.5, no less than 6 in each. We would not require GMAT scores. Okay, for the application of this thing, the average age of the students is 35 to 45. That's one thing. And also, the student would definitely require 3 years of work experience. That's one thing. 3 years plus work experience is recommended by the university. Yes, we accept 3 years of bachelor's degree. But if you have 3 years of bachelor's degree, in that particular case, you need to go through the interview for the application. So this was brief about MBA. The rest other things would definitely be clear to you by Lakshmi Overseas Consultancy, right? Okay. So this was about the session. This was about UNBC, the academic requirements, intakes, the location that we have, and of course COVID-19 situation and how to tackle the situation. So thank you so much for having me over here. Thank you for being patient. Stay safe, stay connected. Thank you so much.